Hi, I'm Graham Steele, Head of Product for the Cybersecurity Group here at SandboxAQ.
And I'm Kristin Gilkes. I'm the Global Innovation Quantum Leader at EY. So Graham, there's a lot of talk about quantum computing these days. And with all of the excitement, there's also serious concerns around digital security.
Most people probably aren't aware how central cryptography has become to our everyday lives. It protects our banking information. It keeps us private online. It protects national security. The problem is, once we have large, stable quantum computers, they'll be able to break much of the cryptography that we're using today. So very widely used internet security protocols like RSA encryption will all be vulnerable to a large error-correcting quantum computer.
Exactly. The future problem is that bad actors can hold on to encrypted data now with the goal of decrypting it later when quantum computers are reliable and large enough. But it's also a now problem. When I talk about PQC, I try to remind people that this isn't just about implementing something for a future threat. It's about how do we take advantage of the absolutely most cutting-edge technology that's available right now with our cryptographic standards and add additional layers of protection right now for the current threats.
Every business should be figuring out how they're going to transition to PQC or post-quantum cryptography. These are new cryptographic algorithms that resist both the attacks of today's bad actors as well as resisting quantum attacks in the future. The problem is that doing that migration is a massive undertaking.
It is absolutely a massive undertaking, and it takes years and not months or weeks. To top it all off, companies also have to manage and upgrade their legacy cryptographic systems in a way that's compatible with these new PQC measures. The threat of these cyber attacks is ever so real, it's ever so present, and it's not just about PQC and upgrading these systems for the future threat of quantum. It's really about how do we protect that perimeter better today? And if we can leverage advanced techniques just to add additional layers to their perimeter now, that just boosts that whole security of that particular organization. And it's one of the reasons why I'm especially excited for the collaboration between EY and SandboxAQ.
Yeah, I'm excited about it too. With EY's strategic knowledge and capacity and SandboxAQ's technology, I think we can really help all businesses to face this problem. What we do with our technology is first help a business identify where they have critical assets that are protected by this cryptography that's going to be vulnerable. And then we can help them transition to PQC seamlessly and leave them in a crypto agile posture so they're able to react to future threats. And it's really the synergy of the deep understanding that EY has of their customers, where their most critical data is, how their business really works, that allows us to prioritize the way that we roll out that technology so they're actually getting improvements in their cryptography right now today, as well as getting ready for the future.
It's such a great opportunity for companies. The need for cryptographic agility and the need for quantum readiness cannot be overstated, and we're here to help each step of the way.